Let's look at supervised learning. We split this between regression and classification. Regression, we're looking at like an average line called a regression line of the data points. Classification classes the data points in different classes, like blue, green, and yellow. Let's look at linear regression. So remember, here we're going to use the best fit line to the data. Also, we're interested in the slope, which is called the coefficient, and where the line intercepts the y-axis, called the intercept. Let's have a look at linear regression in orange. We start looking at supervised learning. We can open up data in a file. So we move the widget onto our canvas, and here we're going to use a data file called data.csv, comma separated value. Now we're going to load that data, and if we want to see the data, remember we can use the data table. Connect the widgets and let's click on the data table. Here we've got cars, the model of the cars, the volume and the weight, and also the CO2 output. Now, that last point, the CO2 output, is important because in supervised learning, we need a target. Now we can see this if we use select columns. So we've got select columns and we're going to join the data to the select columns. If we click on this, we can see here, first of all, we've got a target, the CO2. So the supervised machine learning will use features to work out what the target should be. Now we're going to start off with just one feature, the weight of the car. So how good can we determine the CO2 output by the weight of the car? Let's have a look. So let's close that window. We're going to use test and score. So we can get the widget and we're going to join the columns to test and score. Now we used some type of machine learning algorithm, so we can look inside model. And which one are we going to use? Linear regression. So we move linear regression and connect the data to the linear regression. Now, if we click on the linear regression, we can see we have the settings and we're going to keep them as the default. Now, we want to connect the linear regression to the test and score. So we connect the two widgets. And now to see the test and score output, we're going to use another data table. So now we connect the test and score to the data table. So we had the file, we have our data, we choose what our target is and what features we're going to use. Here we're just using weight. We have linear regression, the machine learning module, the algorithm, test and score. We have some statistics here. The main thing we need to check is that we test on the training data. Want to make sure that's selected because we're training our model using this data. Now, if we look at our results, we have a table. So we have our car, our model, and our weight. Also, we have the actual CO2 output, and we have our estimate in our linear regression. In supervised learning, we have two options. We have regression, which you can see is a continuous number, and we have classification that determines the class, such as A, B, or C, or positive or negative. We can order the columns, so the CO2 output and the linear regression estimate prediction. So we can see it's not great, but then we're only using weight. And finally, we wanted to show you. You click on file, you can see here we have the correct types. The volume is numeric, weight is numeric, CO2 is numeric. Also, we have the role. So these are features and this is the target. If it's incorrect, you need to change that. So that's in the file. We can see the type and the role of the data. So if you have any problems with your model, perhaps this is the first thing to check. Now we'll make a separate video on linear regression because there's quite a lot more that we haven't shown you. We talked about the slope and the intercept, which we can look at. We have many statistics for evaluation, and also we can look at other things related to linear regression, such as the correlation. So there's many other things that we need to look at for linear regression, which means that that's worth its own video by itself. So look out for that. We start off classification with k nearest neighbor. Here we want to know if the green circle is either a red triangle class or the class of blue squares. Now if we look at the nearest neighbor, so k equals 1, it's a red triangle. So that would make the green circle in the same class as a red triangle. Now if we use k equals 3, we can see we've got 2 red triangles and 1 blue square. So 2 to 1, we still stay with the red triangle. What about if k equals 5? Well, here we look at the 5 nearest neighbors. And here we've got 2 red triangles and 3 blue squares. So here, the majority is the blue squares. So that's a different class. So it depends on how many neighbors you want to use. We always use an odd number, but that's k nearest neighbor. Let's have a look in orange. We start off getting the data using file. We're using this example CSV file. Now we're going to use k nearest neighbor. So let's get k nearest neighbor, KNN for short. And we're going to use test and score. And also this time we're going to use predictions. So we're going to join our data to test and score. K nearest neighbor. Let's start off with 1 neighbor. And we join test and score and predictions. Here we have our predictions. We can see our classes. So let's start off with zeros. We have zeros and ones and ones. So that's quite straightforward. If we wanted to visualize that, you can look at a scatter plot and we can see we have our k nearest neighbor classes represented by blue and yellow. Now what happens if we add or change our KNN, our k, to 3 nearest neighbors? So we can look at our predictions. Now this time it's not as straightforward. We start off with the zeros. We can see that 4 out of 5 zeros is quite straightforward, and 3 out of the 5 ones are quite straightforward. But in the middle, where we had these middle data points, we have 2/3 majority, so 2 out of 3 neighbors, and in one of them it's incorrect. So it's not so easy with 3 nearest neighbors. If we want to look at that in our plot, it's saying that these 3, we have 2 out of 3 neighbors on one class. And what about if we move up to 5 class, 5, k equals 5. If we look at our scatter plot, we can see this middle point is quite difficult to put in the right class. If we change it to the actual classes, it belongs to the blue class rather than the yellow class, and yet it's probably closer to these yellows than it is the blue. So that's k nearest neighbor. Now logistic regression is similar into linear regression in the fact that it uses the regression line, but it is classification. So we're not looking for the prediction of regression, we're looking at which class the data point's in. Let's look at logistical regression. We're going to use a file here called tumor, and we don't have much data. Let's have a look. We can use data table, and we can see we've just got a length of a tumor, and when it's low, it's likely to be negative, but when it's high or long, it's likely to be positive. So we're going to get logistical regression. We're going to use test and score, and also predictions. So we connect our data, we connect our logistic regression, we're going to use the default settings, and then test and score, connect to predictions. If we look at our predictions, we can see our logistical regression, when it's positive, logistical regression predicts it's positive. When it's negative, it predicts 5 out of 5 correctly, but 1 incorrectly. So although it's negative, it predicts it as positive. We can see that. You can see that it's a kind of middle length. We can see that using a confusion matrix. So let's type confusion matrix. So here we've got positive and negative. 0 negative, 1 positive. Now we can see that the predictions of positive were actually positive here. So 6 were correctly identified as positive. Negative 5 were correctly identified as negative. That was 1 error. This one was predicted as positive, which is 1. But actually it was negative. So you can see in this confusion matrix, these are true positives, these are true negatives, and here we have a false prediction, a false positive. These are negative, false negatives, which were 0 in this case. So this is a confusion matrix, and that was logistical regression. Another supervised learning algorithm that does classification. Support vector machines. This sounds very complicated, but we've kind of done this before. But instead of using the best fit line, we have this decision line. And instead of using all the data points, now we're only using the closest one to determine where this line is. The closest data points are called support vectors. You can see here, you've got the closest one in green and 2 that are in blue. The gap between these is called the margin. So the decision line is the best fit between these closest points that are called support vectors. Let's have a look at this in orange. Let's start off getting the data. Now we're going to use the data from a file, and if we want to see that data, we can look in a data table. So we have several columns, and we have purchase, gender, age, estimated salary. Now we need to know what the target is. We're going to use select columns. So let's connect our data, and now we have our target purchased, and we have our features, age and salary. Now we're going to use support vector machine. So we start off SVM. And we need our test and score. And we need our predictions. So let's connect the data. We're going to use the default settings. So let's find predictions and connect. And now we can see our predictions using the support vector machine. We've got a lot of purchases, 0 and support vector machine. Perhaps there's too much data here and we can't really understand it. So let's go back to our confusion matrix that we saw last time. So here we can see we've predicted negative 233 times correctly, 11 times incorrectly, and positively prediction 132 correct and 24 incorrect. So that's the evaluation of our model. Let's use another example for support vector machines. But this time, let's get a data set. So the iris data set is very popular for machine learning. So we're going to get the data set. We click on it and we want to look for iris. We can type in the word if we're not sure where it is. Here we have iris. So now we're going to load that data set. Now we want support vector machine again. So we have SVM. We want our test and score, and we want our predictions. So let's connect data, support vector machine. Let's look at the predictions. And we can see here, there's quite a lot of information. So again, let's look at our confusion matrix, connect a test and score. Okay, so here we've got three different types of the flower iris. And the first category, 50 out of 50 times, it was predicted correctly. So we've got the data and it's putting the data, using the data to predict which class the flowers are. So is it in this type A, B or C, if you like. We can see here it's got, out of 150, it's got 146 correct and two. Each time we've got the two categories B and C, we've got two errors. Okay, so that was support vector machines, which again, classification, again, supervised learning. Well, there's more classification machine learning algorithms that are supervised learning, but that's enough for this video. Remember to click like if you've gained something from it. We'll continue with more supervised learning, then unsupervised learning, and also the confusion matrix in detail. So if you want to know when the videos are released, remember to subscribe and click that notification bell.